Stick around, everybody. Fresh case crack, Bowman draft, dual box. Good luck. I hope you guys stick around because we're going to be opening up first off the line. Honors in Phoenix returns, breaking that out of the archives. This song ends what we call cold. It's just going to go. It's going to end cold. Q101, and they would go into their next song. All right. Oh my God, this stuff weighs a ton. Holy cannolis! I'll stick around. It's another fresh case crack. Fresh case cracks. We'll do your packs for those of you who won in the trout. John, is John in here? Does he even know that he won? Jeremy must have made these bigger. Did you make those bigger, Jeremy? Here we go. Fresh case crack. Time for a super. You love the fresh cracks? Don't we all? I didn't see any bonuses in some of these other breaks. Two or more items, Tom Brady's. No, that's tonight. It's the list right here. Josh, Denning, and Dave. Denning doesn't even know he's probably in a football break tonight. Carter, you're going to Hawaii? No, you're not. Stop lying. Go to Maui. That is correct, Martin. Martin gets it. He knows his stuff. That is very true. That is my business model. It's called added value. Added value promotions. All those jerseys, helmets, bonuses, boxes, packs. That's how I give back to my customers. Plus, it sits on your shelf and you look at it every day. And who do you think of when you see your dope items? You think of me. Your favorite breaker. Oh, I got that from Chris's break. Number to $4.99, Jesse Franklin. The give it away model. Added value promotions, Martin. AVP. He is a Brave. And what that means, where them Braves at? Kyle Hearns, Hitman. The Hitman is back. Look out. The Hitman returns. Hearns returns. Here I go, going through the same packs twice. You guys love it when I do that. I set them down and forget if I went through them or not. I like to keep them on screen, though, if I can, because that way, if you're missing an auto, all the cards are right there in view, and you can go through them again. Well, this is... Oh, wow! That's dope. Zach Veen. I know he's a dope player. Where did he go? Zach Veen. Is he a Rocky? Yeah, Rocky. And the Rockies are owned by Joshua B. That's pretty dope. These is nice. I think I will post another Blitz mix. I will not make it a $750 one.
Hey, what happened?
But I will post another one that will be half that with some dope stuff in it. I got a Patrick Mahomes helmet, but I'm just not ready to part with it, not gonna lie. I could easily put that in a Blitz mix. Build it over maybe two different breaks. Call it a day. Just not ready yet. I mean, a $10,500 Blitz mix with the Jaguars. See, that's the thing. I was a breaker customer for a long time. So I would spend quite a bit of money on breaks, and I would get the Jaguars. And it was like, well, damn, that sucks. But if there was a jersey to hit, and I won that jersey, or an item, which there wasn't, nobody did it. But I was like, man, I wish these guys make so much money. So much money. Such profit. They're having a blast. How are they giving it back to their customers? Put in a jersey. Put in a helmet. Do a weekly buy-in-to-win thing. Give away a $1,200 Mike Trout photo. They're going to buy in anyway. It's just giving it back to them. At least you're still alive and you have a chance. I think Martin's going off the rails. I think Martin's losing his mind. I really do. I really think Martin's gone crazy. He has just this pandemic and stuck in the house and just doing mortgages and cards. I think he's gone nuts. Sammy Infante, Washington. Sammy Infante is a Washington National. Nationals owned by Dave K. I do know Dave's kids watch this show, so you know. What is the line on the Super Bowl? Chiefs by a million? Not happening, Carter. It's going to be a game. You thought some of the Super Bowls in the past few years were thrilling. You know, the Eagles one and the freaking meltdown one with the Falcons. There's been a lot of really good Super Bowls. This one's going to rival those. The drama and the high drama and the... It's going to be that. 3.5! So Kansas City's getting 3.5? Doesn't the home field usually get an advantage? They're at home, man. You know, with all those fans. Maybe they can yell at Tom Brady like they yelled at LeBron. Tom Brady's getting 3.5 points. Where do I place that bet? Oh, my God. Giving Tom Brady 3.5 points after he signed up for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and takes them to the Super Bowl, and he's getting 3.5 points. Come on. It should be a straight up pick 'em. Even money. I get they're defending champs, and they are super dope. Fast as F. So fast, those Chiefs, man. A lot of speed. Love watching them. Great coaching. Second to none when it comes to coaching. Literally. And the plays that they choose and the just everything. It's like if the Chiefs were a video game, every category will be like a 10. Special teams, 10. Offense, 10. Defense, 10. They're just dope. It's Jay Groom, number to 99. There's a very high percentage of MVPs or quarterbacks. I don't remember the exact number, but it was pretty high, like 60% or something. Number to 150. Yeah, what's the money line? So what if you just bet? What if you just bet the Buccaneers to win straight up on the money line? What's that paying? Plus 400? Jeff Criswell, number to 150. +130. Eh. They're 3.5 point underdogs, but they're only +130. That doesn't make sense. Does it? That doesn't make sense. Something's up with that. That tells a lot. They're like two score underdog. If it came down to it, field goal, another score. But yet, you only get paid 130. In the NFL, it is. Like, aren't spreads in the NFL, you don't see them too higher than 6, 7, 8. Can I bet with my Bitcoin? If you can find me a wager place that takes Bitcoin, I'll bet. I'll cash out some of my Bitcoin. Oh, that half point sucks. That always kills me. Every time. Because they'll get it close. They'll get it to a field goal. With that half a point. It also keeps ties tight, Martin. There's no ties can be. There's no pushing. Right, that's what I'm saying. So 3.5. Five isn't really much. That doesn't do anything. Six does. It's like either 3.5 or 6. Here's my idea that I was going to do. I was talking to JD about it. Oh, bet US takes Bitcoin. All right. I'm going to put it all on the Patriots. My Bitcoin's up massively. It's kind of funny. I've been buying Bitcoin for like 8 months. Jared Schuster, 150. So here's my original idea. And time flies by. You guys know me. It just flew by. I wanted to do a big promotion. I was going to give away a huge sum of money. I'll say it's undisclosed at this time. But I was talking to JD and I was going to give away a large sum of money if somebody could pick the actual final score of the Super Bowl. And what I was going to do was run like 2 weeks of breaks And then every break, run the randomizer, and one person gets in. So it'll be maybe a dozen people or so, or maybe 20, whatever we were going to do. And everybody would log their scores. I would make a video. I would show their picks. And then we would watch the Super Bowl. And whoever picks the, if somebody were to pick the actual final score along with the winner, they were going to win a lot of money. Like $12,222. Break credit. But I decided against that. Patriots won't win. You don't think the Patriots are going to win? This guy is a 57th overall for the Rays. But I still may do that promotion. But with the PlayStation, what is it, a 5? PlayStation 5, win a PlayStation 5. I'll probably email JD about that. I might do that. All football breaks starting tomorrow. I'll include the Blitz Mix. I can probably take a couple of people from that. You said Patriots. I know, I was making a joke. I don't know. You guys know my theory. I like to look into the future. I like to look on Monday morning and think, wow, can you believe that guy did that? He left the mighty Patriots and he goes to the NFC South Tampa Bay Buccaneers and wins the Super Bowl. Like, that just sounds right. That does not sound too crazy. That sounds like something that's going to happen. Plus, it ain't easy to repeat. So there's odds against them there. Somehow they're favorites still. Number to 75, Caden. 78th overall. And these are all my personal takes and opinions. This isn't from the talking head shows that I've heard him say. This is just how I see it. In fact, I have to turn off the talking heads anymore because all they do is try to be controversial and I'm over that. If I did that promotion, the only way to do it is whoever picks the actual score, right? I can't be like, whoever gets the closest with your score. Like, that would, I mean, I guess you could. How do you figure that out? What if they're both, what if someone says 38-27? I don't know. That's too much for my brain to figure out. I gotta make it simple. Pick the freaking score. You win. Martin said 38-27. I didn't even see that. I didn't see that, Martin. I could increase the pot, you could pick. Maybe, I don't know, I want to make it dope, and I should have run this started 2 weeks ago, but I might get more bang for my buck if I do it right now in a short period of time. It's kind of like not releasing your movie trailer until a week before it comes out versus 3 months in advance. you release it too early, people get glazed over about it. If I do it now, it should be all the talk of the town. I'm going to take a shot at the Super Bowl promotion. I want to do props. I like to do props. I haven't done it. I don't think I did it last year because I was out of commission. I had a bad tooth at the time, root canal, so I was, that weekend sucked. But I've done props before. Like, I would put out a tweet and say, okay, if Patrick Mahomes throws 2 touchdowns in the first half, retweet this and win. So Mahomes throws 2 touchdowns, everyone is retweeting, and I take that tweet, retweet it, and award items. Here's Ed. All right. It's a lot. We got squares. Tyson, how are we going to do the squares? I'm going to run them Saturday night. Is there a program or something I'm going to use to assign those numbers? The hell are we doing with that? Yeah, props are fun. The other thing you can do is sell a divisional spot, right? Sell a division. 8 spots in a division. Each spot, I'll random a prop, and that becomes your prop. Whatever the prop is, we'll find some cool ones, but we'll keep them pretty reasonable. Not first score as a safety. That's not fair. The problem with the prop game, and if I sell 8 spots, is what do I do if all 8 props hit? You know, like, I'd have to, you got to jack the spots up, spot price up to cover in case every prop hits, I'll go backwards. Or I could take all winning props. All winning props will go in the randomizer for whatever item is in that divisional break. Free box or break credit, something. If your prop hits, you go in the randomizer. Didn't I use an automated system before? No, I used that automated system where it assigned it itself. There's a nice auto Pete Crow Armstrong, PCA. Unless it's been 4 years already since I used that program. 19th overall. Right, so you just list 100 names, run it. 1 goes in 1, 2 goes in 2. That's pretty easy. He probably left because he didn't win the Trout, and he was probably mad. Not mad at me, but just disappointed. He really wanted to win that. Who didn't? The Mets. So he probably clicked out. What's up, Dave? Sorry I didn't get the chat today. I was on a Zoom call thing. Meeting. Imagine that. There's Tyler. He's good. Dave K came by today to pick up his bounty of jerseys and helmets and cards and monsters. Joe Burrow 101s. It's named Tyson. I love Tyson so much. I'm going to give Tyson a big old hug next time I see him. He'll be like so awkward when I do. I'm going to give him a big freaking hug. 150, Tink. Auto number 2, it's Caden. Number to 75. It's a Zamora to 250. Seymour, number 3, 250 Rays. Number 4 is Jeff Criswell. There's a Green Jay Groom, 99. There's a Daniel Lynch, 499. Fulton to 50. Sammy Infante. 4. Here's 5. This was dope. Zach Veen on the national team. On card auto, of course. And Jesse Franklin. A couple other colorful things. Yeah, Zach Veen is nice. What's up, Frank and Eddie? I was watching highlights from the Rumble last night. Saw Edge came in and won it. Not sure how I feel about that.